style this weekend with a prestige visit from one of Italy's top sides.
Reading's season was over. Even so, 5,000 supporters filed into Elm Park yesterday to witness some unfinished business. The Italian Serie A side, Genoa, made up the numbers in a friendly. But the only statistic which really mattered to the autograph hunters was the fact that manager Mark McGee had led Reading to the second division title. Club captain Keith McPherson collected the silverware. And his colleagues received championship medals. In pouring rain, these local heroes soaked up the applause.
Well, it's a great moment for everyone. The fans, everyone's turned out a miserable day, unfortunately. But this is just the, obviously what we've been working for all season. It's a great moment for us all.
Everyone's really worked hard and have done really well. I mean, it's unbelievable at the moment. We're just enjoying it at the moment. We've got a game to go after, but I mean, we're just enjoying every minute at the moment. It's unbelievable.
So Reading have their reward for a memorable season in which they were the outstanding team in the second division. The campaign began last August. The Royals were on the road. Their destination, Huddersfield. The introduction of new fullbacks, Dylan Kerr on the left and Ray Ranson, immediately gave the side a rounded look. In the Huddersfield goals, keeper Steve Francis must have been thinking his decision to leave Elm Park that summer might backfire. Reading were convincing 3-0 winners. The bookies soon cut odds of 25-1 against Reading winning the championship. Reading players were instructed to pass the ball. They did, to great effect. And the Royals had a solid spine. West Indian goalkeeper Shaka Hislop stepped in to replace Francis. Adrian Williams' defending ability had Premiership scouts checking the route to Elm Park. Phil Parkinson gave the midfield a competitive edge and chipped in with a few goals. But it was Jimmy Quinn's finishing power which set Reading apart. In the air or on the floor, Quinn was quite exceptional. His timing against Plymouth in September, perfect. This in the final minute. Bonus for Reading was that even if Quinn wasn't scoring, Stuart Lovell was. 22 this season and few more valuable than the two which saw off challenger Stockport. It rounded off a sequence of 15 league matches in which Reading remained unbeaten. The attractive football and favourable